Hey guys, A-Train here, casting Game 3 in the semifinals match between IBM and Microsoft. We are going to be seeing Memcpy, or should I just call him Memcpy, from Microsoft, and his opponent is going to be Zai from Team IBM. So it will be a Zerg versus Zerg matchup on Waystation, and Waystation, one of the few maps in the pool where there are four player locations, but you can only cross-spawn. So as you can see, both of these players should know exactly where to go. And they have spawned on the short side. Blizzard making this map so that they could have two types of games pan out here. This is oriented for more of a rush style. And either way, probably wouldn't change too much in the Zerg versus Zerg matchup. Memcpy, I think right now is 10-2 in the Cards Gaming League. And Zai has not lost yet, so he's 8-0. We'll see how he fares against this currently Master League player. And Zai, always a good sport, always comical. And if you ever watch his YouTube, you'll know his character just by watching those games. And neither player going for the early pool opener, so no rushing, even though they are the rush distance. And these overlords will meet in the center. Overlords want to get good positioning over all these units. So now it just becomes a question of when do these players start their pool? And it looks like Memcpy will be the first one. And Zai is going to go for the hatch first. So he feels pretty safe to defend against any early pool openers. And it kind of goes, 50-50. If Memcpy is able to make these early Zerglings pay off, then his opener will have worked out for him. If Zai can defend with the later pool opener, then this hatchery will have paid off for him. So we'll just see what happens. But both players still going for an expansion, so no all-ins here. And Memcpy not going for gas early, so there won't be early speedlings. We do have gas for Zai, so interesting opener, and I think unless he's able to do some damage with these Zerglings, I think Zai's hatch first will actually pay off a little bit here. Memcpy does get to start the queen a little bit earlier, so he'll be injecting and creating larva a little bit sooner. But we do have the gas now for Memcpy, and Zai getting his as well. I haven't seen Memcpy play enough Zerg versus Zerg games, but I know Zai likes to go for the meatless play. We'll see what he ends up doing here, but part of the After Hours Gaming League is trying to do builds that you don't do before, so you can keep your opponent off guard. This Overlord trying to get chewed away by this Queen. Not sure if he will fall. Memcpy's got it on chase, the Queen. And looks like he might be able to get away here. Ever so slowly, one more hit. 18 on this Overlord, and Zai forced to pull back this Queen, trying to get the kill, or is he trying to go home? He can't decide. We do have another Queen on the way for Memcpy, and a couple more shots, so he does get the Overlord. Memcpy being persistent with it, sticking to it, did get the kill. Couple Zerglings on the way for Zai to get some scouting information, and Memcpy sees this. He's gonna try and shoot them away, and looking at the work account, 25-22 in favor of Memcpy. Zergling speed is on the way for both players. We do have the Baneling's Nest also on the way for Zai, so this is pretty standard stuff. We do have the spine now down for Memcpy, so he's playing a little bit more defensive and going for the Baneling's Nest as well. So, nothing too exciting yet. We'll see if Zai's able to do any damage with these 12 Zerglings that are on the way in production. He's trying to shoot away an Overlord. We get some scouting down. Oh, and Memcpy sees all of these Zerglings! And there's so many Zerglings here, so it's going to be a lot of Zerglings to defend. The Baneling's Nest is almost finished, so now Memcpy forced to make a bunch of Zerglings and only make some drones as well. The worker count is heavily in favor of Memcpy, so if Zai doesn't do so much damage here, he's not going to be able to do... He's going to be a little bit far behind, trying to get as many kills with these Zerglings. Zerglings going to work on the Zerglings and the The Spinecrawler does fall. Baneling's now on the way as well. And Zaim almost able to get... He gets a kill over there on the Queen. Queen's falling in some... forces the cancellation of that Spinecrawler. Are there more units on the way for Zai? No, it doesn't look like it. And he's going to end up losing these Zerglings as well. Now we have to evaluate what has happened after this game. And now, looking at the workers, 23-22, all evened up. And now a few more Zerglings on the way for Zai. Is he going to be able to do a much better damage? And, oh, gets a good Baneling hit there. And kills off four Zerglings. So, now there's a lot of Zerglings for Memcpy, and all these Zerglings getting cleaned up. So now Zai has to decide what to do. He's got a Spinecrawler going down for himself. So now the counter should be coming from Memcpy. There are a couple Banelings being morphed in as well. 29-26. We'll end up seeing how this works out for Zai. And needs to be sure not to lose his queen. Right now he only has a couple queens right now, so... and the Banelings getting in position. Needs to make sure he gets good positioning on these Banelings. Three Banelings at the front. A bunch of Banelings in for Memcpy. And this is going to be a ton of Banelings. We'll see if they can get good hits off. And the Banelings. Oh, so many Banelings in the main base and at the bottom of the base. A great Bane hits for Memcpy. And one more Zergling after that's all said and done. 33-26, so now in favor of Memcpy. So that was a good engagement there. And Zai now down in the worker count, 8. But he did have some drones on the way. And he's got a couple more Banelings. After this is all said and done, it looks like it's pretty even. But I think Memcpy still has a slight lead, 68-60. And going to have to continue to keep making Banelings. These Zerglings are on the way. There's so many Zerglings here. 19 Zerglings. And only a couple Banelings. And he does get an explosion. He gets a nice explosion there. And now four Zerglings going in. And is he going to be able to get one more kill? No, he doesn't get the one Baneling to go off. And gets only a couple Zerglings there with that one last Baneling. This Queen might fall as well. And the Queen needs to survive. And it does. Whew. And this is really intense. 40-34. Right now, in favor of Memcpy, we have so many more Zerglings on the way for Zai, and it's 22 in production. So it's kind of going back and forth. Do we have any layer tech? We do have the layer now for Memcpy. He's got the Spire on the way. Layer's halfway done for Zai, and he's a little bit behind in that regards. So he's going to have to make some more happen with these Zerglings. And 43-37 now in favor of Memcpy, and he's got that Spire on the way, and Lair's just so late for Zai, so he's gonna be falling behind. And now he's going for Roaches. He decided not to get the second guess, and now he's going for Roaches. I wonder if he's gonna try and push here, but once that Mutalis Spire finishes, I think Memcpy will be in great position. So Zai, pretty even here with the Zerglings versus Zerglings, and the tech would be the interesting part. He does have the Spire. Nope, he's going to go for Hydralis. So he's countering the Mutalis with Hydralis instead. So he's going to go for the Roach Hydra. So we'll see how this works out for Zai. So many Banelings being morphed in. And interesting that he would morph in Banelings instead of making Mutalis. Only three Mutalis now, and this is a lot of Banelings. It's been working off the four gas geysers. Zai's only got the third. And here come the Banelings. And I think this is so many Banelings. We have some Roaches on the way. Some are Banelings going in. And Memcpy might be able to snipe a few more as well. And not able to get as many Banelings. Oh, he gets about five right there as well. 48-31 in favor of Memcpy, and he's doing great in this matchup. There is the good game. So Microsoft goes up 3-0 on IBM, and IBM will be facing the elimination game.